大家好，是贝欧刘，你们最喜欢的辅导老师贝老师。今天我们来看第19课，面试的两个语法。今天我们来看什么呢？第一个是 you're blank, you're blank。第二个是叫做。OK，首先第一个语法是 you're blank, you're blank。So adjectives 也好，verbs 也好。你们可以用这个语法来 describe that something changes in accordance with A. So the more X, the more Y. Cause and effect in a positive correlation, right? So a common saying is 越早越好. That just sort of exemplifies how you use this. The earlier, the better. So when you think about that, even in English, the earlier, the better. There's nothing really connecting those except our knowledge that that's a set phrase. And the earlier, the better is saying with increasing earliness, increasing goodness. So that is what we're applying with this. So you've seen 越来越, more and more. This is showing a correlation based off of two, well, based off of what, the first condition. So enough of that analysis. Let's just get straight into some leads in. So, 第一个, 我越紧张就越解释不清楚, 解释不清楚. The more nervous I get, the more unclearly I explain, the more unclear my explanation becomes. So here the subject is 我 in both of these. So the more I am 紧张就越 解释, the more I explain. If we use 解释 like as a verb, then yeah, 解释不清楚, 解释都不清楚吧. But if it's two separate ones, I, the more I am 紧张, the more my 解释, the explanation is 不清楚. 接下来, 第二个例子, 他 很着急，车，哦，他越着急，车越开。Oh, no, okay, start over. Boom, that didn't happen. 他很着急，that is setting the basis of the context for the sentence. 他很着急，he's very urgently just hurrying around right now, rushing. 车越开越快，车越开越快。The more that the 车 is going, 开 to drive. So see here, it's not an adjective. 车越开越快. Verb, adjective. The more the car goes, it's getting faster. So it's going 越来越快, basically. And 第三个例子. 明天你尽可能早点来，越早越好. So again, looking at the one I was saying before. 越早越好, the earlier. The better，所以你可以用这个越什么越什么来做一个一个建议，like，oh I suggest，you know the earlier the better，or 可以用它来描述一个情况，to describe a situation，like 车越开越快。那第二个语法叫做 blank，so。叫做 is a verb complement, so 叫 to call verb, and 做 then becomes a complement for that verb. So what does that generally mean? That this is mainly a form in formal speech. Like you see a lot of those, 看成, 被成为, all these type of verb complements. So 叫做, to be called, but to be known as, something is called. Made. Something is like made called this. So let's look at some examples. 第一个, oh, and as I said, 被成为 can be subbed in for 叫做 as well. And 被 introducing the passive voice. So 第一个, 他们从海外归来，因此被叫做海归. So they came home, they returned home return here because lie, then that like directional complement shown us is tagui lie, 是归去. So they come back here. 他们从海外, they're from somewhere else. 归来这里, like they came back home from abroad. 因此, therefore, 被叫做, and again, passive voice, 被, they are called 被叫做, because who is doing the jiaoing is somebody else to them. 被叫做, 海归, so they're called like overseas returnees, whatever you call. I don't know what you call this in English, I'm not gonna lie to you. 第二个, 我们把一年级的学生叫做新生. We taking the 一年级的学生, we to the 一年级学生, to the freshmen, or whatever. 叫做. So here it's not a 被叫做 because they're the ones 叫ing, they're the ones doing the action. 我们把他们叫做新生. The newbies, the new people up in here. And 第三个, peanut. 在中国南方有的地方叫做土豆, 北方叫做花生. So here we got peanut. 被叫做. So here, like, we're introducing the thing that's getting 被叫做 at the beginning. But then they're saying 在中国南方有的地方. So here it's like in these places it is called, they call it 叫做土豆. And then the 北方人叫做 question, which is really crazy because 土豆 to me is potato, period, point blank. And I don't know where I learned that from and who told me that, but 土豆, if you hand me a peanut, I don't know what I'm gonna do. But 花生, yeah, it's most definitely 花生, in my personal opinion, 对我来说. Because if I say 我对土豆过敏, people are gonna be like, so, but 你是美国人, 你没去过麦当劳吗? Like, they'd be like, girl, these 薯条 are all out here. What do you do? The curly fries? The 麦当劳, the 薯条, like, how are you living life? I'll be like, oh, no. I mean, 花生. 我对花生过敏. That's just a very, like, confusing concept, which I never really considered before I got into this book. So, the more you know. 好的，我说完了。 我们来练习和复习. OK, 复习的部分, 上次我们看了之一, 那我问了你们 finish 完整这个句子, 长城, Lord, 长城是什么之一? 长城是中国的名胜古迹之一, you could say 最长的, 最长的墙, the longest 墙壁之一, I guess. 那指南针呢? 你们应该学过, 指南针是中国历史的四大发明之一, 指南针是 compass. Compass is one of the four great inventions of ancient China之一. For the rest, 剩下的是 造纸术, the creation of paper, the paper technology, right? 指南针, 火药, gunpowder. 还有 印刷术。 OK, 千千万万, 请你 describe. And this could be whatever you want, but I had something in mind. Beyonce concert. 在 Beyonce concert 的演唱会中, 千千万万的人在观众里面. There's 千千万万人 in the 观众. 观众是 指的是 看某个 看某个表演或者看某个活动的人, audience. OK, 那 applications to Harvard, 千千万万的哈佛大学申请表. So 申请表是申请 paper 的申请 like packet, application itself. 申请是动词, to apply. And the bonus was, Harvard 是什么样的大学? 哈佛大学是美国名校之一, 或者也可以说 哈佛大学是有名的，最有名的大学之一，等等等。 All right, and for the 练习呢, 用月 verb adjective, 月 verb adjective. 第一个, 请你 draw connections. 学习太极拳, and 喜欢太极拳. What's the correlation? 第二个, 开得快, and 我紧张. Anybody who has had me in their vehicle knows that is the truth. Even if you're not 开得快, just 越开, just the more you're driving in general. I'm Jinjiang, clutching those handlebars. Okay, now, 叫做, question one. This is one. 在美国, 大一生, 大二生, 大三生, 和大四生, 有什么特别的名称? So, 大一生, 大学一年级的学生, 大学二年级的学生, 等等等, 他们有什么样的名称? 你可以用英语学, because that's the point. Okay, 我很期待你们的答案。好的, as always, 谢谢大家的注意。辛苦了, 我们下次见。Bye bye!